despite the terror attacks near Kabul airport. The two suicide bombings yesterday are believed to have killed at least 72 Afghan civilians and 13 US troops. Joe Biden has warned he'll make those responsible pay for what they've done. The president, who's lost two of his own children, says his thoughts are with the victims' loved ones.
We have some sense, like many of you do, what the families of these brave heroes are feeling today. Get this feeling like you're being sucked into a black hole in the middle of your chest. There's no way out. My heart aches for you.
The Islamic State group says it was behind the bombings. A senior US general says his forces are prepared for more attacks before they withdraw from Afghanistan by the end of the month. Farouk has a wife and five children stuck in Kabul trying to get back to the UK. Following the warnings of an imminent attack yesterday, he told them to leave the hotel, which was later targeted.
I had a call from my MP to say, where's your kids? And I said, they're waiting in there. They say to me, move from there as soon as possible, because there's going to be a terrorist attack. And I called to my wife and I said, just move from there. Just go to some safe place to go there and just move from there.
In other news this morning, Manchester City defender Benjamin Mendy is due to appear in court charged with rape and sexual assault. The allegations have been made by three people and date between October last year and this month. Scotland Yard says around 300 arrests have been made following this week's Extinction Rebellion protests in central London. Traffic was brought to a standstill at Oxford Circus yesterday. More disruption is expected over the bank holiday weekend. Seven locations, including Switzerland, the Azores and Canada, are to be added to the government's green list for travel. Thailand and Montenegro are moving to red, meaning arrivals will need to quarantine in a hotel. The changes come in on Monday morning. Sprinter Maria Lyle has won Paralympics GB's first athletics medal of the Tokyo Games. She claimed bronze in the women's T35 100 metre final. In the city, the FTSE 100 will reopen at 71.24 after closing down 25 points yesterday. The pound buys $1.36 and €1.16. And the weather, a mixture of cloud and some warm sunny spells, the odd light shower. Feeling cool near eastern coasts and where it's cloudier, a high of 23 degrees. From Newsroom, I'm Simon Conway.
Summer's here, and Ocado's got a scrumptious deal just for you. Half in the sun, half in the shade picnickers, get 3 for £7 on our picnic picks, like Higgity sausage rolls, holy moly guacamole, and mini innocent smoothies. And you back garden bronzers, you can you do my backers? Sun cream from £5, including Ombre Solaire. However,
control of the country, or, as some sources are suggesting, did they possibly aid the suicide bombers? Now, in the UK, they called a Cobra meeting. I'm sure that rattled the Taliban, and the Prime Minister has spoken afterwards.
The overwhelming majority of those who are eligible have now been extracted from Afghanistan, and we're going to work flat out, getting people through as fast as they can still. We're going to keep going up until the last moment, but that was at the peak, what I've been saying over the last few days. We also fully expect that those who want to leave Afghanistan after this phase one, if you like, are allowed to do that by the Taliban, and we use all the influence that we can bring to bear with the political or economic, diplomatic, as we said at the G7, to encourage the new authorities in Afghanistan to do that.
And to the US, Washington, Joe Biden.
Even in Kabul, as you all know, terrorists attacked that we've been talking about, worried about, that the intelligence community has assessed, has undertaken an attack by a group known as ISIS-K.
Afghanistan. Secretary, also Business Secretary, Work and Pension Secretary, and Health Minister of the governments, both Tony Blair and Gordon Brown, 12 after 7, to the military perspective, particularly the US military perspective. Let's bring into conversation Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Davis, who's a foreign affairs analyst and retired Lieutenant Colonel from the US Army, who has served in Afghanistan. Thank you for coming on, sir. Can I read to you the words of someone who you probably know, or certainly know of, General H.R. McMaster, a former US National Security Advisor, who Lieutenant Colonel said the following: "This is what happens when you surrender to a terrorist organization. We are seeing the establishment of a jihadist terrorist state in Afghanistan, and all of us will be at much higher risk as a result." Is he right, Lieutenant Colonel? Morning.
Good morning. I could not more strongly disagree with McMaster. I've known him for 20 years. I fought with him in Desert Storm and think the world of him, but he is just dead wrong here. And all the evidence shows it. I mean, the idea that we could have just continued this endless war and somehow came out in a good place, it just belies the fact that the overwhelming evidence on the ground, which I've personally observed through two separate combat tours there, and all the information since, was that this was always a sham. This was inevitable, what happened here. It could have happened a bit earlier, a bit later, but it was always going to happen because the Taliban has been on a relentless operation to overtake the country, really going back into about November 2017. And they've been on a very methodical process, and they continue to take part after part. And if Biden had decided to stay, if he decided not to get out, then the Taliban would have eventually came to Kabul in a military operation, not in a position like they came in this time where everything collapsed. Then Biden would have been faced with a horrible choice between either accelerating and bringing more troops in and ramping the war back up again, or withdrawing under pressure. And that would have been even more catastrophic, if you believe that, than what we had here. This war was lost. It was lost a long time ago. This just solidifies what we all know.
But Lieutenant Colonel, and I bow to your military's obviously knowledge, does the evacuation have to be so chaotic?
It had to be chaotic, and it's important to understand the reason why I say had to. It was inevitable because the biggest mistake that we made was trying to accomplish with military power a nation-building operation which never had a chance. And we've known this. Look, I wrote in 2010 that if we don't make major changes, we would lose this war. And in 2012, after coming back from Afghanistan, I said, it's getting even worse, and here's the specific reasons why. But our leaders knew this, and instead of being honest about it and say, in 2014, Obama could have ended this war in a great shape because the Taliban only possessed about 6% of the country at that time. The Afghan government and military would have actually had a chance. But because we wouldn't be honest about it with anybody and continue to pretend like things were going on, the Taliban methodically made progress year after year until finally they were too strong for the Afghan government. And then now that we have the chaos, precisely because we've been unwilling to be honest for 20 years.
Lieutenant Colonel, two tours of Afghanistan. What is your abiding memory of your time there or the people with whom you met?
Gosh, you know, there's a couple of almost contradictory ones. One, the country is so gorgeous and so beautiful and so many wonderful people. And that's the one. But then, unfortunately, the indelible ones are, us lying, our senior leaders lying to the American people while I was on the ground watching it crumble and go in the opposite direction and seeing so many people sacrifice their lives to cover over this lie. Unfortunately, that's really the ugly memory that I'm going to carry around or I'm going to drink.
Really grateful for you staying up early into the morning or late at night, however you've made it. Appreciate his early hours for you in Washington. Thank you. A foreign affairs analyst and retired US Army Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Davis speaking to us from Washington. Thank you for that. All right, we'll obviously get your views. What now? What are the British upon it? What of the intelligence that was unfortunately so chillingly accurate yesterday, 24 hours on? What are the latest intelligence soundings? We'll try and get that from the Defence Secretary later. Also coming up, there has been movement on those traffic lights for travel.
What is really enraging the travel industry is what hasn't changed. And Turkey, crucially, remains on the red list. Very popular holiday destination, of course.
That's the Doyen, author, travel editor, Simon Calder. More on that later in the hour. Plus the premier football star who's facing 4 rape charges.
27-year-old Benjamin Mendy, a World Cup and Premier League winner, is charged. charged with four counts of rape, and LBC's Tom Dunn at Chester Magistrates Court.
And Mr. Mendy plays a course for Manchester City, 7:50, 7:17 now, sorry, LBC News headline, Simon Conway.
President Biden has promised to hunt down those responsible for the terror attacks near Kabul airport and make them pay. At least 72 Afghan civilians and 13 US forces were killed in yesterday's two suicide bombings. Both Britain and America say they will continue with efforts to evacuate people from Afghanistan as Tuesday's deadline to withdraw troops approaches. The weather mostly dry with a mixture of cloud and some warm sunny spells, a high of 23 degrees.
LBC Travel, I'm Joanne Webb. Traffic still being held on the M20 eastbound at Junction 4 at Leybourne. It's because a car has hit the central barrier. One lane stays closed on the North Circular Road westbound just before the A10 junction at Edmonton, where a van has broken down. Very slow on the A12 southbound to the Abbott Road interchange. This is heading towards the Blackwater Tunnel. It's all down to those emergency repair works and only one lane is open. On the trains, minor delays on London Overground services now between Surrey Quays and Clapham Junction, and on the Underground there are minor delays on the Northern Line.
LBC.
This bank holiday weekend at Boots, discover unmissable deals on a wide range of your favourite products. Save up to 15% on iconic fragrance and premium beauty brands to boost your beauty regime, including Yves Saint Laurent, Prada, Drunk Elephant, Lancôme, Fenty and many more. Shop safely, in-store, online or via the Boots app. Amazing bank holiday deals at Boots. Feel good as new. Exclusions apply. Most Boots stores end September 1st. See in-store or boots.com for details.
Call Nick Ferrari now, 0345-6060-973. This is LBC.
This season, watch over 400 live games on Sky Sports.
Bring it on.
The biggest Premier League games.
Don't you just love it?
The EFL. The Scottish Premiership.
They've never shown.
And for the first time, the Women's Super League. That's over 400 live games. TV required. Further terms apply.
When your dog's asleep, you can only guess what they're dreaming about. But we do know what they'd think about pets in a pickle. They'd love the extra peace of mind it brings. So for pet insurance policies as unique as they are, get a quote today at petsinapickle.co.uk.
Virgin Money's brand new Brighter Money bundle is here. Switch to the M Plus account for brilliant rewards.
Refugees and US Marines murdered side by side is the very powerful headline on the eye. Dozens feared killed in wave of explosions at Kabul Airport. is the Financial Times, the Daily Telegraph, 12 US trips to Ankabul.